all of these changes in Infosys have to be seen against the backdrop of what's happening fundamentally in the IT services industry. And to that extent, at a certain level, is it too late?
TCS talks of a global market share of 1.4% of the annual IT spend. Corporations worldwide are still using systems and applications which are 20, 30 years old. They are not going to junk it overnight. Whether growth will come from those applications? No. But that is a bread and butter business, and those are stable revenues which are going to stay around for the next 10 years, if not more. So growth will of course come in newer applications, newer services. But the past revenues doesn't get washed away. So to that extent, the opportunity is huge. And two is there is scope for newer services, there is scope for newer market. One doesn't need to dramatically look at changing anything. It's not that the company needs to dramatically change its services or anything. It just needs to get its sales force back in and go and attack the client. The market space is huge.
Now, what are the three or four most important things that he needs to do, he needs to address?
One of the key issues that I personally feel Mr. Vishal Sikka will face is the fact of leadership. Because leadership is going to be very, very critical, and this is going to be different from the background from where Mr. Sikka comes from. Leadership and attaining leadership in a space which is an end-to-end services business is a different ballgame altogether. So I think that established norm of leadership which will, make him say from the ramparts that we have arrived, I am your leader and I will lead you into this blissful future where we are going to be doing different things, where the valuation of this company is going to go crazy, where this entire big kitty of money with which we haven't done too much is going to be spent in a purposeful manner, which is going to deepen valuation even further. So I think all of this is going to be the key challenge.
I think time will tell whether we are in 2.0 or 3.0. And I think that still while the changes are happening, the only thing that has actually pulled Infosys up in relation to the rest of the market is the rumor that there's going to be a buyback, as well as there's a rumor that Nandan's coming back. And if either of those rumors come true, then perhaps that's good for some price in the stock. That's why it went up a couple of hundred rupees in the last couple of days. But I think that I'd watch and wait, and I'd be a lot more comfortable in the pure business side of a TCS rather than an Infosys at this point.